This is Jim. I want to welcome you to the video, and I want to thank my subscribers for subscribing, and want to beg you to please do not unsubscribe. Now that the perfunctory fucking stuff is out of the fucking way, we can get on to business. A lot of people are yapping about Bush eating the Constitution. And I can tell you right now, I don't give a fuck about what the fuck he does to other fuckers who may be trying to destroy the Western world. And to tell you the truth, the Constitution is not what gives us freedom. It is not the thing that established our liberties. The Constitution is the thing that limits the federal government. It controls the federal government. That's what it's designed to do. So I can take it or leave it. I don't give a fuck about the fucking Constitution. That isn't the thing that provides for our freedom. You know what it does provide for? It provides for the IRS to send me some sort of thing that says the examination process installment agreement request. What the fuck are they talking about? These fucking fuckers from the IRS are saying they want money from some return I did a couple years ago. They think I owe them money, man. And another thing that's insane about this country, and very, it's embarrassing, to have tolls at bridges, on highways. It's fucking embarrassing in a civilized country to have someone demanding money from you just to pass through their area. What the fuck do you think taxes are, man? I just got this thing from the IRS. I've been paying taxes for decades, and they want more money. This is insane. All those fucking amendments, the whole thing, they don't abide by the Constitution anyway, man. And another, well, let's go back to the Articles of Confederation and then remove the whole state concept. Why do we have these different states with these different laws? You know what I mean? I'm free to carry my gun in Connecticut, but if I go to New York, they have different laws where I'm not free to carry the gun. But in Vermont, I don't need any concealed carry permit at all. This is a mess, this fucking country. And they're worried about these other issues. Keith Olbermann on the TV there. Oh, habeas corpus. Bush is attacking habeas. Fuck the fuckers who are trying to destroy America. I don't give a fuck. They aren't under the Constitution. You know, American citizens, you must get some benefit for being an American citizen and for paying taxes. You know, there must be something. We must get due process for that reason alone. You know what I'm trying to say? So what we have in this video here is a little bit of stuff that may or may not be of interest. I went to Slide Mountain yesterday afternoon, and I got a little bit of footage on the summit, and I think descending on the trail there. The trail is made up of these big rocks, and it's really pretty devastating on the ankles. I have like oversized ankles. I could never get cowboy boots because I could never stick, my foot would never fit in there because the ankle would block it. And I always wanted to get cowboy boots with the snakeskin material and everything, but I could never do it because my foot would never fit in the fucking thing. But so I did, my ankle is a little sore from yesterday because when you step on these rocks coming down on Slide Mountain, all these rocks slide around, so oh, all kinds of twists happen. And today I took someone's boat from one marina to a different marina that winterizes the boat, and it was very windy. There was small craft warnings going on, and I should have brought the little waterproof device that I put on the camera, but I forgot it. And it was too, the water was just coming over the bow of the boat. I couldn't safely video anything because salt water is like battery acid, basically. So there you go. That's about it, I think. All right, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video, and take care. We'll be right back. You know, all you might have to do is have a discussion on this whole 9/11 thing. You know, I find it hard to believe that an amateur can operate those jets and hit specific targets like that. I just like an explanation. In other words, can they, if they have GPS coordinates of a certain site, can they just type those into a computer on the jet and it automatically gets you to that point? Also, why did those buildings just basically dissolve? And also, the Pentagon is not an easy target either. That's pretty low in altitude. It's just a, you know, just some question, because they base a lot of their policy on 9/11 changed everything. It's, you know, I just want to be sure that 9/11 is as it has been presented. I guess what concerned me is that the poor guy that flew into an apartment building the other day basically had very little damage to that apartment building. And I've seen construction in Manhattan, and there are big, heavy steel and iron beams that make up the construction of these buildings, and they're very solid. I can't imagine them dissolving, unless the World Trade Towers were built differently. So maybe we can address these questions at some point.